Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.4 to the public. That means that it's available at the same time everywhere around the world on all supported devices. So if you have an iPhone 6S or an iPhone SE all the way up to the iPhone 12 Pro Max, you should have that update available. Now, if you're not seeing it, you want to go to your settings, go to General, then Software Update, and you should see the update. If you're not seeing it there, tap on Automatic Updates and turn off Download iOS Updates, and then check again for the update. You should see it there. And so once you go ahead and check again, you should see it, and it will be a fairly large size, as this is a big update from 14.3, for example. And depending on which version you're coming from, it could be as large as 5 gigabytes. So on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, it was over 4 gigabytes, but it can vary depending on device. Now let's go ahead and take a look at what's new. Now I'm running iOS 14.4 on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, the iPhone 11 Pro Max, my iPhone 11, and iPhone 6S Plus. Apple also released iPadOS 14.4. I'm using that on my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. They released WatchOS 7.3, HomePodOS 14.4, tvOS 14.4, and we're still waiting for macOS 11.2. But either way, there's a ton of updates, and if you have any of the supported devices, you'll be able to install it right away. Now, if you're a beta tester and you want to make sure you're on the final version, all you'll need to do is remove the beta profile. That can be done under Settings, General, and then scroll down, tap on Profile, and remove the profile. If you're a beta tester or a developer, you'll have this, and if you don't want to get any more future beta updates, remove it, and you're good to go. Reboot, and you'll be on the final version. You just had it early if you already updated to iOS 14.4 RC. Now let's take a look at the build number, and then talk about what's new. So if we go to Settings, then we go to General, then About, you'll see the build number is 18D52. This is the final version of iOS 14.4 released to the public, and so that build number lets us know which version we're actually on. Now, there is a modem update in this particular update, so that means if you were having connectivity issues and you were on an iPhone 12 Pro Max, for example, and you're coming from iOS 14.3, you should have a modem update, which should help with connectivity, whether that be with 5G or 4G. You may not have it on all of the older devices, though. It just depends. Apple released them on some devices. Now, the first new feature has to do with QR codes. Now, we've had the ability to scan QR codes using our camera for quite some time, but Apple is now giving us the ability to scan smaller QR codes. So if you just bring your camera in front of a QR code, tap on whatever link it opens up, you can open that link. They've given us the ability to scan much smaller QR codes. I haven't seen really tiny ones myself, but we now have that ability. Now, the next thing I think a lot of people will appreciate, and it has to do with what's connected via Bluetooth and volume. Now, there's a newer feature that we've had for a little while under Settings, Sound and Haptics, and Headphone Safety that will sort of notify us or adjust the volume based on when there's a loud sound to make sure that our ears are not getting blasted with super loud noise and damaging them. So in order to combat this, Apple's brought in this headphone safety feature. However, when you're in a car and you're using music through a stereo, or maybe you're using, say, a hearing aid, you don't want those volumes to change because you set it differently than you would if you were using headphones. So they've added a feature under Bluetooth in your settings. So if you go to Settings, Bluetooth, and then you select an accessory, so a car, for example, you'll see device type at the top now. If you tap on device type, you'll have the option to select from car stereo, headphone, hearing aid, speaker, or other. And so if it's an AirPod, for example, it will know that it's a headphone. But for a car, for example, car stereo, you want it to classify that so it doesn't adjust the volume based on it thinking you're using headphones, for example. So this should really help with that feature overall if you're not able to disable it in the headphone and safety feature, or if you just want to use it and make sure it's working properly. So I'm glad that they've added that. Now, the next feature is specific to the iPhone 12 series phones. So the iPhone 12 mini, the iPhone 12, the iPhone 12 Pro, and the iPhone 12 Pro Max. They've now given a notification if your camera module is not original or not an Apple camera module. Now, I'm not sure if this has to do with the aftermarket sort of refurbishing of iPhones, but right now, if you try and swap a camera from, say, an iPhone 12 Pro to an iPhone 12 Pro Max or just a similar phone, it won't allow you to do it. So Apple will now give you a notification if it's not a genuine camera. Now, we saw this with batteries, so they're letting you know it's not a genuine battery. However, with cameras, I'm not sure why they're doing this, but it's just something that they've changed, and it will give you a notification if you have that now. Now, the next feature has to do with HomePod. And if you have a HomePod mini, for example, and you update it to HomePod OS 14.4, you'll now have the option in a U1 equipped iPhone for it to actually transfer just by being near the HomePod, transferring your music, for example. So on the iPhone, you can see already it's bringing down HomePod mini right. I have a HomePod here. As I bring my phone closer to it, it vibrates more and more as I get closer and then jumps the song to the HomePod. And so it's a really great way to transfer music from your phone to a HomePod, but it only works on U1 chip equipped iPhones. So basically the iPhone 11 series and 12 series, where they have a directional chip in them to allow it to see this. So this works really well. And as I bring the HomePod away, it goes away, bring it close, it comes closer, and then gives you more information about the music at the top. So you'll see right here, it says HomePod mini right, and then it's got information about the song. And again, as I bring it close, you'll see it flash and then it jumps. So we have that as an option now. It works with phone calls as well, and it's a great way to transfer music instead of just tapping the HomePod. So as you get close, I think you'll enjoy it once you get a chance to use it. Now, to go along with music, if you have AirPods Max, they've added the ability to use Siri by using the word hey in front of it, and then you can activate it. So I tested this by actually putting my iPhone down, then I went into another room with my AirPods Max on, playing music, went into another room, shut the door, and then actually said hey, and then Siri activated. I asked for what the weather was. It responded and gave me the weather information. So it works now with AirPods Max. It worked prior to this with AirPods Pro, for example, but now you can use hey and then your keyword and you'll get a response. So there's not really a audio response. You just have to ask a question and Siri will respond. So that's been added to iOS 14.4. Now, the next new feature has to do with exposure notifications. If you're in a local area that has exposure notifications and you have one of the apps installed that enables it, you can go into your settings now and then go to exposure notifications, tap on the app here, and then tap on it again. And you'll see we now have a new option for automatically notify others. It says your public health authority can ask you for one-time access to your random IDs if you're diagnosed and positive. This will allow them to notify others who have been exposed. So these notifications don't identify you, and this has to be enabled. You don't just have it enabled by default. So if you install one of those apps and you enable exposure notifications, then you'll have the option. Otherwise, it won't be here at all, but it's something nice that they've put into this update to help others around you. Now, the next thing has to do with tracking, or anti-tracking, I should say. Now, in all of the betas and the release candidate version or GM version of this update, there was the ability to have anti-tracking features in iOS 14 that Apple talked about earlier on. That apparently is here. Whether or not they enable it, they haven't said, but that feature is here, and basically it stops things like Facebook or Instagram from actually tracking you across different websites. And here's what the notification looks like. So you don't have to allow this, but you now have the option to. And so if you'd like better privacy, less access to what you're doing on your phone, this will keep you protected and keep everything private. So they've added this. Hopefully we'll see it enabled everywhere soon. So as far as new features, that's everything they've mentioned and a few that they haven't. So far, I'm not aware of PS5 support as far as the controllers or Xbox Series X controller support. Some have gotten the PS5 controllers working supposedly, but they have not officially added the controller support. So it may be in a future update. Also, many people wanted to know if they've resolved the green tint issue that some people have on iPhone 12 series. I've only seen it on one phone out of about 9 that I've looked at. And what that means is if we go into, this is sent to me by someone named Jury on Twitter, friend here, you'll see there's a little bit of a green tint to the display on certain situations in certain darknesses or brightnesses. So some phones have this. iPhone 11 series phones had this last year and they fixed it via software. I would expect them to do the same. They just have not addressed it in this update, according to Apple. So it's not anywhere to be found in the documentation, nor does it seem to be fixed. So hopefully they'll fix that in a future update very soon. Now, as far as what they've actually fixed, though, that they have talked about, the first thing has to do with the iPhone 12 Pro specifically. They did not say 12, 12 Pro Max. They just say 12. And that has to do with image artifacts appearing in HDR photos. So if you take a photo, you have HDR enabled. Maybe you take a photo like this. You had some artifacts in here, things that just didn't look right. That should be resolved in this particular update. So you shouldn't see those anymore if you were seeing those prior to this. Now, the next thing that they've fixed has to do with the fitness widget. So if you're using your iPhone with an Apple Watch, and then you're using the fitness widget, before this update, sometimes the activity data was not updated properly. So now it should be updated in real time or close to real time with all the accurate information. We had this issue a little bit with other widgets prior to this update. They fixed them in previous updates. Now they've fixed the fitness widget. Now, the next thing they've fixed, I think a lot of people have been looking forward to, and that is the lag with the keyboard. So if we go into notes and I type, hi, how are you today? You'll see that the keyboard was nice and fast. It also gave me suggestions, which weren't working 100% all of the time before. Now this is fixed and the keyboard should no longer lag, not just in notes, but throughout the OS, including messages. So if you had issues in messages, they'll now work properly. There shouldn't be keyboard lag anymore. So that's a great thing to see. And they've also fixed the issue where when you're in messages and you have multiple languages enabled, the language that you're using may not show up properly. It may switch to a different language. So now that should be fixed. So if you're using English, it should show up English. If you're using Spanish, Spanish, and so on. Now, the next thing has to do with the news app using CarPlay. If you're using News Plus and you have the audio stories enabled, and maybe you're trying to listen to one of these stories, it will now work properly after you've been given spoken directions or use Siri. Before, it might not resume. It would sort of just pause and hang there. You'd have to start it yourself again. Now it should resolve or resume properly, unlike before. And then finally, the last thing that they've mentioned that they've fixed has to do with switch control and accessibility. So if you go to your settings and you go to accessibility, and maybe you're using switch control, prior to this update, switch control may prevent phone calls from being answered when you're on the lock screen, if you had this enabled. So if you have switch control enabled and you're using it, it may give you some errors. Now it shouldn't. So it should work properly. We'll turn that off, but it should work properly now, and you should be able to answer calls like you could before. Now, also in this, there are security updates. So there's a bunch of security updates that should make your phone more secure and fix any known problems. I'll link those in the description if you want to check out all the different security updates. And they have CVE numbers, which you can check out and see exactly what they've fixed. Now, with the iPad, with iPadOS 14.4, Apple has only fixed a couple things and added a couple features. The only things that they've mentioned are the option to actually recognize those small QR codes with the camera, as well as classify Bluetooth for audio issues. So those are the only two things they've mentioned with the iPad that they've updated, as well as fixed the issues with the keyboard that we had on iPhones as well. Now, prior to this, using iOS 14.3 and iPadOS 14.3, battery life on my iPad was not great. It seems to be better. I don't know that it's 100% back to where it was before, say, 14.3, but right now it seems to be better. And yesterday, I used it a couple hours and it went down quite a bit. So in standby, it seems to be using a lot of power on the iPad still. I'm not sure why that is. I did use it for a lot of YouTube, but you'll see 2 hours and 41 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 10 minutes of screen off time yesterday, and the battery is way down to 31% and it was plugged in. So this update, while I have seen good battery life, I think it's an app using it, but on the iPhone, battery life has been pretty good. So let's take a look at it under settings. We'll go to battery here, and my battery health is 100%. Updates don't affect the battery health. They're just rechecking the actual physical battery capacity or capability after the update. So you may see that number adjust. I wouldn't worry about it. It just adjusts as needed. But yesterday, I didn't use it too much, but you'll see 2 days ago, I had 5 hours and 2 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 3 minutes of screen off time, and used 50% of my battery. This puts us right back up to what we would expect, 10 to 12 hours with the iPhone 12 Pro Max. And so I've had really good battery. By the time I go to bed, I have 50% left. I've been using it all day usually and have no issues. So I'm really happy with this update, at least on my iPhone. And I've seen a lot of people in the initial beta updates that have been using this say the same thing. saying that most of the battery issues they were having were fixed. So that's great to see. Now, performance is good as well. Even on older devices, such as the iPhone 6S Plus, performance seems to be fine. Scrolling is nice and smooth, going into different apps. So we'll wait for music to load here. Once everything's loaded, it's nice and smooth. If we go into, say, you'll see there was a little bit of lag, but the camera seems to be fine. Snapping a picture is fast. So it really shouldn't be any different than 14.3 as far as performance. And that's true on all of these devices. So whether that be the iPhone 11, iPhone 11 Pro Max, iPhone 12, or an older phone like the iPhone 6S Plus or iPhone SE. Now, should you install iOS 14.4? I would say absolutely at this point. It's definitely something that I always recommend for security updates, a few additional features and bug fixes, especially that keyboard lag that people were having. There will be more fixes in the future. No software is perfect, but at this point, with the battery fixes that most people are seeing over 14.3, I would definitely recommend it. Now, if you're looking for future updates, such as iOS 14.4.1 or 14.5, whatever Apple decides to do, we should see those updates within a day or so. Usually Apple pushes out early beta testing versions very quickly after the public releases. So of course I'll keep you updated as soon as we see that, but we're not sure exactly what they're going to do as far as version number, because this time last year, Apple pushed out iOS 13.4, but not until March. So we're in a little bit different territory here, but I'm glad to see they're pushing out fixes quickly. And hopefully we'll get one for the green tint, as well as I know some people are not really liking the yellow tint that they're seeing on their iPhones. The yellow tint really is just the phone being more accurate, as far as I can tell. Generally, when you color calibrate a display, it seems to be a little bit more accurate. But as you can see next to the 11 Pro Max, the whites do look a little bit different. They look a little warmer on the 12 Pro Max, and I would like the ability to at least shift that a little bit more than you can do already. So maybe we'll see something in the future about that, but Apple has not addressed it with this one either. So that's it for iOS 14.4. Now, after a couple days, I am seeing that lag again. So when you're going to close apps, sometimes it will lag. You swipe up, it closes the app, but sometimes it stutters a little bit along the way. So hopefully they'll address that in future updates. For some reason, that's still present. Some people have it, some don't. So hopefully Apple can fix it, as it's sort of an intermittent problem that some people are seeing. But that's it for iOS 14.4. Hopefully we'll see some new updates fairly soon for beta testers. And of course, I'll keep you updated as soon as those are released. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.